Okay, I want to make sure she had her right side up. Thank you, Caroline. Okay, last but not least, Caitlin Collins. Where's my Caitlin? Yes. Yes. Really key, this young lady is very interested in health. She's doing very well in her math and her sciences, but above all, she's realized the love of music has thrilled her soul that when she needs to calm down, she'll go to the piano and play. And you also sing, right? I'm trying to encourage her to sing. But what she does, you do play percussion. All right, so she's a percussionist also. So keep on your music in all realms and let it lift your spirits as she studies the health field that goes into the health field. Right? Okay, so now I need to do something very special. I want to bring up Nia Lampkin.
Where's Nia? Is she missing?
So before Nia comes, I need young Maddox to please come forward.
Yes.
I need young Maddox to please come forward. It's a little hard, but Maddox and I have been together for how long? For 5 years. I'm so sorry that, I'm departing, but I don't want him to stop. He has taught me some interesting music. What have he taught me? Tell me the name of one of those pieces. It was one of those pieces from it was so much fun that he showed me how to find this musical piece on the internet, and he mastered playing a good portion of the piece. It was so much fun that I even tried to do it, and he was doing it better than me. But what's so fun is that he's very creative. He's very bright, very creative, and he's taught me, again, a good measure of patience and love of different type of music. But I want you, Maddox, to keep on studying your music. I want you to keep on being a professional in your academics as you work towards your future. You hear? And don't be afraid. Step out and do your better best, your good better best always, okay? All right? Love you. All right. Okay, Nia. My fingers are moving. Nia's wondering, why am I coming here?
Come on, Miss Karen, can we talk about this? Come on.
Part of a parent-teacher association. Just raise your hands. And when the teachers ask you to help out as a parent, Do you just walk away? You help out, don't you?
Yeah.
I don't have to ask too much from Mia over the years that I've been in South Florida, or let's say Homestead. But whenever I've asked for help for anything, this lady steps right up and says, I can do anything. She's like half of my brain, if not all of my brain. She helps me with everything. And I know she helps all of you in some way or another, family, friends. But you want to talk about a good woman, this is a good woman. She's more than good. I don't like the word good, it's too general. She's an excellent person, she's genuine, and she's sincere. And I want to thank you very much for all of your support. And you're like a sister. Also, okay? And I just have a little token of appreciation to give to you. You can't get away. Please enjoy, and remember me.
Of course.
I will be back. Yeah. I'll bug you.
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you so very, very much for your support. I really appreciate it.
So I'm going to take the mic.
So, I mean, Ms. Carrington has been a blessing to all of our families. She's the reason Kai got into the high school that he's in. So, the piano teachers were amazed by his ability at the time. It takes time, and we know. And I don't have the patience, and I'm a teacher. But Ms. Carrington has made me, as well as I know all of you, a better parent, because she's pushed them so hard in such a loving way. So we're not really losing a piano teacher. We are going to miss our family member, a motivator. And I don't know how many times I feel like I had a parent intervention after not practicing as much as we should have and juggling the time frame, especially this week and the week before the testing. So when we found out the news, I think we took a while to tell the kids. And so we found out today. Mm-hmm. But we've all been mourning the fact that we're not going to see her every Sunday or call her whenever we need to. And can you just listen right now? Tell me if this is right when they're practicing. So, Ms. Carrington, we are going to miss you. And because of that, everyone in here chipped in for a gift for you, as well as the kids created a special memorial. Oh. Memorabilia, I should say, for you. So, we want to say
beautiful.
Thank you.
Now,
I know this was short, but Ms. Carrington is being modest. She received a promotion that she's been praying for years. And we know things happen in the way that they're supposed to. We just didn't want it right now. At least one more year, right? But this is what she deserved, and we know from what she has blessed us with our own children, that she more than deserves this. So even though this is sad, we're very happy and proud of you for your achievements, in addition to what you've done with our children and the church's children. I mean, after she leaves with us, we leave on whatever day, Sunday or makeup day, she's going over to the church. There's pathfinders, there's church meetings. I don't know how she does it. It's a lot to deal with. So we just want to say thank you. We're going to miss you. And we hope that they appreciate you just as much as we did.
Mm.
Thank you.
Thank you so very much. Thank you. I'm not going to talk for long because I'm a crier too. But I couldn't let you leave without knowing how much you've impacted our lives. Even more than the kids, Ms. Carrington's like a counselor. She listens, and I mean, she really listens. And I lose my patience because I had all three of my kids very little. But she would always encourage me that it's going to get better. We're going to get bigger. It's going to get better. Trust me. And then she would share stories about her boys. Your broken piano. But I know that what God has for you is
just so much more. And you are amazing. We love you dearly. Our kids are going to miss you. And you cannot ever be replaced, no matter who comes. We left here for about 3 years in Port Davis. We had another teacher. She was wonderful, but we kept comparing her to Miss Carrington. And it was unfair to her because her huge shoes to fill. So when we came back, it was just like, oh, this is amazing. But we understand, and like Mia said, we love you and we are proud of you, and we can't wait for that. We're gonna miss you. That's it. Okay.
This time I wanted to open it up for anyone that wants to come and be able to let Miss Carrington just get a token of our appreciation, because we know it is a Sunday, but it is our Sunday with Miss Carrington. Our last recital right now in 2018 with Miss Carrington. So if anybody would like to come, you can feel free. Just come. Kai, were you going to say something? Oh, okay. No, it's up to you. All right, so just fall behind Kai, and we can go ahead and let Miss Carrington know how much we love her, because I can say I was taught from my father to give a person the roses while they're alive. And Miss Carrington, because of your dedication and because of my father, we know Miss Carrington. And he's in sleep in God now, but at his memorial service, because of Miss Carrington's dedication, Kehlani was able to play and sing, and our first music and our music all the way was done by Miss Carrington. So when you say there's things where you have to let people know how much they impacted your life, you're one of them.